This is All India Radio. In the program Spotlight, now we bring you a discussion on Atal Innovation Mission's Apps Development Module. The participants are R. Ramanan, Mission Director, Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog, and journalist Neelab Srivastav.
The challenge of coronavirus pandemic is continuing, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi, in the backdrop of world and India battling the COVID-19 challenge, it's a daunting challenge. And at this time, the Prime Minister did talk about the Atmanirbhar or the self-reliant Atmanirbhar Bharat, developing indigenous technologies. And in that context, the Niti Aayog's Atal Innovation Mission yesterday on July 11th launched the ATL App Development Module for school students. And this was for school-going students countrywide. The aim of this app or the aim of this network module is that the school students get to develop their own apps, innovative apps. They can play with the technology. Mr. Ramanan, you had yesterday, while launching this network and module for children, had said that we are going to leverage the tremendous demographic dividend of India. Is this to catch them young, as we call it, or to also develop the scientific temper among the students?
As you are aware, Atal Innovation Mission is a national initiative. Actually, it was the brainchild of the Honorable Prime Minister, and it has been launched under the auspices of the Niti Aayog in order to create and promote an ecosystem of innovation and entrepreneurship across the length and breadth of our country. Now, our country has, as the Honorable Prime Minister has identified very eloquently in his speech regarding resurrection of the Indian economy and Atmanirbhar Bharat, that there are five pillars on which the Atmanirbhar Bharat stands. And one of the very important pillars is the pillar of demographic dividend. We have 1.3 billion people. We have 1.4 million schools in our country, 10,500 engineering and related institutions, and 39,000 colleges. And we have more than 115 million young students who are going to be entering into the workplace over the next 5 to 10 years. So the Atal Innovation Mission has been seized with two things. One, how do you create a culture of innovation and problem solving and create an innovative mindset in the young students at university level, school level, and even at the industry level? And the second is, how do you create this ecosystem of entrepreneurship so that these innovative students get a chance to express their potential, their creative potential, through innovations that are relevant to our country? And one of the very important initiatives has been the Atal Tinkering Lab, where we have launched over 5,100 Atal Tinkering Labs across 660 districts of our country, so that every school which has an Atal Tinkering Lab, 500 to 600 students from that school between grade 6 to grade 12 will have an opportunity to interact and play with the latest of technologies like 3D printers, robotics, IoT, miniaturized electronics, and augmented virtual reality. These are do-it-yourself kits using which young students are able to solve problems in and around their community through tinkering technologies and through the latest technologies. Now, one very important aspect, because of the mobile revolution that has swept the world and particularly India, and the mobile communication devices along with internet and wireless communication and long distance communication and new technologies like 5G technologies coming, the ability to extend the power of an innovation to reach across to the remotest parts of our country through an app, a mobile app, which is integrated into the innovation, is crucial. Not only does it help you to reach across to the remotest place, whether it is a hilly district or a coastal district or an agricultural place or rural India, but also it enables you to use the back-end technology with which innovations are being developed most effectively. And therefore, the Atmanirbhar Bharat App Innovation Challenge was launched recently, a couple of weeks ago, by Meiti, Atal Innovation Mission, and MyGov. And this was to trigger a world-class app development in India for meeting the innovation challenges that Atmanirbhar Bharat depends upon to be solved. And parallelly with that, we thought it is also very important at Atal Innovation Mission to be able to launch app development module for young students. Because today, app development has evolved from, you know, just programming to plug-and-play mechanisms because of the advancement in technology and the advancement of tools. And so we have launched probably one of the largest school initiatives for app development learning. It's an app learning module which we have developed along with our partner, Plesmo. And this has been actually launched yesterday to all the schools, not only which have Atal Tinkering Labs, but also for all the schools who don't have them. Because this is an online module, it is a step-by-step module where the student learns how to go about developing an app. And so from just being an app user, the opportunity to become a great app developer becomes very important. And Atmanirbhar Bharat is very much dependent upon world-class apps made in India, not only to solve and address the problems that India has, but also to be able to be used elsewhere in the world.
When I was reading about this entire initiative of the Niti Aayog, I also came across a point where it says that there will be a periodic teacher training sessions under this for children and kind of an online monitoring sessions or classes. Could you please elaborate on that?
What we have done is there are two modules which we had introduced earlier. One was we introduced the modules on app development for teachers and mentors. And the second one which we have done is app development for students. Because it is very important for the ATL in charges in our schools who are actually managing the Atal Tinkering Lab, that they also know what app development is all about. And this is a three-week workshop where more than 1,300 teachers from India got involved, learned about app development, and developed an app in order to get a certificate from the Atal Innovation Mission. Now, that was very encouraging for us during this lockdown period when the lockdown had started. Atal Innovation Mission has launched what are known as Tinker from Home modules. And we have introduced modules so that students as well as teachers and mentors of these tinkering labs, they are able to learn from home concepts on artificial intelligence, game development, 3D design, and now app development. And these have been open both to teachers as well as to mentors, because it is very important for our teachers and mentors to be able to understand how to use all of these technologies so that they can guide and motivate the young students. So there are step-by-step learning modules for the teachers and the mentors and step-by-step learning module for the students. And we will continue to evolve from basic to intermediate to advanced modules so that the students are able to go and develop very, very complex apps even at a young age.
For the benefit of our listeners, school-going young friends, listeners who would be wanting to know more on this, Mr. Ramanan, are we looking at some kind of specific apps to be developed by the students? And also, what kind of analysis would be done when we judge or test the apps that have been developed by the students?
No, actually, we are not limiting the areas in which the apps can be developed because, frankly, Atmanirbhar Bharat, as you are aware, there are five pillars. The first one was the demographic dividend we talked about. But the other four pillars require us to develop apps in multiple areas. To take the pillar of infrastructure, we need physical infrastructure as well as digital infrastructure. And digital infrastructure has to be used in order to reach the end citizen, you know, to provide great citizen services, whether they are in the villages, whether they are in remote communities. We have 715 districts in our country and 115 of them are aspirational districts. And these districts require solutions in education, in medical healthcare, in affordable housing, clean drinking water, electricity, and so on. Actually, you can have apps which can be developed for all of these purposes, which is extending the power of the innovation that you're doing. See, an app by itself is not going to solve the problem. It is an app which is connected to a back-end innovation and which enables the functionality of that innovation to reach across to the end citizen or the end user. That is where the power of the app becomes very high. So we are not limiting the areas in which apps can be developed. It is left to the imagination of the student, and we want the student's imagination to fly high and come up with world-class apps which they think will be beneficial. The other pillar that Honorable Prime Minister has mentioned is the pillar of demand. We have 1.3 billion people, and we have multiple verticals like agriculture, biotech, healthcare, e-commerce, and so on, water management and so on. So we can have apps developed to fulfill this demand.
Now, this is very encouraging to know that, encouraging and very important for us to know that there is no limit, as you said. Sky is the limit. So whatever your talent is, whatever your last thing is, whatever that you feel needs a better system, technology, innovation, you can go ahead with it. Mr. Ramanan, also, what is the entire work of the Atal Innovation Mission as such? And the second question joined with this is this the first time that the Atal Innovation Mission is targeting the school-going students?
No. The Atal Innovation Mission has been in existence for the last 3 years. It actually started off in 2016, but picked up momentum towards the beginning of 2017. And the Atal Innovation Mission focuses, one, creating world-class Atal Tinkering Labs across all the districts of our country so that every school either has a tinkering lab or it has access to a tinkering lab through one of the nearest tinkering labs. And this is to promote a problem-solving innovative mindset in our young school students. The other initiative of Atal Innovation Mission is to launch world-class incubators. Now, why do we need incubators? Each incubator, the government gives a grant of up to 10 crores to be able to foster at least 25 to 30 startups every 2 years. So we have launched about 102 incubators, out of which 70 incubators are operational. And we have more than 1,500 startups who have come out of it. Now, the important heartening thing in this is that over 500 of these 1,500 startups are women-led startups. And we have 3 to 4 women-led incubators. What we want is more and more women-led incubators and women-led startups and women entrepreneurs also to come. Even in the schools, we have 70% of the schools which have Atal Tinkering Labs as girls and co-ed schools. And 70% of the schools are government and government-aided schools spread throughout the country. The third initiative we have is what is known as Atal Community Innovation Centers. Now, these are being set in Tier 2, Tier 3 cities and in rural India so that these community innovation centers can become the hubs of innovation and job growth for these local community-related issues. So if you are in Lucknow or if you are in, let us say, Visakhapatnam or if you are in Sikkim or if you are in Jammu Kashmir, how do we ensure that the innovations that are coming out are meeting the needs of the local community and spurring job creation and spurring innovation there? The fourth initiative is what is known as Atal New India Challenges, where we have launched challenges which will have national impact at a socio-economic level by the creation of products. And these challenges are worked along with the ministry. So we work with different ministries, the Ministry of Health, Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation, Ministry of Textiles and so on. And we launch challenges along with them. And anyone who has a product will be given a grant of up to 1 crore so that they can convert the prototype into a commercially deployable product. And finally, for the MSME industry, we are going to be launching what is known as Atal New India Challenges Arise, which is applied research and innovation for small enterprises, so that we can stimulate Make in India innovation for the MSME industry by launching again challenges targeted for the MSME sector along with the various ministries. So it is a combination of government, industry, academia, and state and local government which come into play in order to create this ecosystem of innovation and entrepreneurship so that we as a country will be among the leaders and in the frontier technologies in being able to progress, leveraging the latest of technologies and the latest of methodology.
Along with the Atmanirbhar Bharat philosophy that the Prime Minister had talked about some time back, he also spoke about the vocal for local, developing indigenous technologies.
Going vocal for local is really to express that whatever is local ingenuity and local innovation that India does can have global impact. And therefore, unless you are able to express it, when you say being vocal, this means giving an opportunity to be expressed on a global platform and let everybody know the talent that is there, the innovation capability that is there, and the technological superiority that can be created because of our demographic dividend. After all, just in the last 10 to 15 years, we have built one of the largest IT-enabled services in the world. And all global companies are flocking to India to leverage our IT-ITES capability. And that is because India has a tremendous intellectual capital and knowledge capital that has been created through its young students and from the universities and so on. When they get an ecosystem of innovation and entrepreneurship, they all thrive and they blossom.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
You were listening to a discussion on Atal Innovation Mission's App Development Module. The participants were R. Ramanan, Mission Director, Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog, and journalist Neelab Srivastav. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. You can listen to it on our mobile app, News on AIR. This program is also available on our website, newsonair.com. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.